check, check. Some say. 1, 2. Buckle my shoe.
To scream it from every mountain top. Your goodness knows no bounds. Your goodness never stops. Your mercy follows me. Your kindness fills my life. Your love amazes me. And I sing because you are good. You are good, and I shout because you are good. You are good to me. Hallelujah! Nothing and no one comes anywhere close to you. The earth and reflect this truth, and in my darkest night, you shine as bright as day. Your love amazes me, and I'll sing because you are good, and I dance because you are good, and I shout because you are good. You are good to me, to me. And I'll sing because you are good, and I dance because you are good, and I shout because you are good. You are good to me. With a cry of praise, my heart will proclaim, you are good. You are good. In the sun and rain, my life celebrates. You are good. You are good. With a cry of praise, my heart will proclaim. You are good. You are good. In the sun and rain, my life celebrates. You are. You are good. And I sing because you are good, and I dance because you are good, and I shout because you are good. You are good to me, to me. And I'll sing because you are good, and I dance because you are good, and I shout because you are good. You are good to me.
Has he been good to you? We praise you, Lord. You're worthy.
You are good, promises. You are hope, you are hope, you have covered all my sin. You are peace when my fear is crippling. You are true, you are true.
Sing no other name, Jesus. Jesus. My heart will sing, no other name. Jesus, Jesus. My heart will sing, no other name. Jesus. Spirit, break down. Spirit break out. Heaven come down. Sing it again. Spirit break out. Break our walls down. Spirit break out. Heaven come down. King Jesus. King Jesus. You're the say that to my room. We want to see your kingdom here. Come on, point to your heart. We want to see your kingdom in us first. The sound of heaven touching. Come on, put your hands together, give God praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Exalted One. Oh,
back to some good altars. When we used to gather in the living room when the ministry was being birthed, we used to sing this song all the time. We didn't have all the musicians. Actually, what do we have? We just had a CD. Put the CD in, and we just a little. The sound system was about. Here's how big the sound system was. It was a boombox, and it was about. It's the truth. And we just worship all night long, and then God would just speak, and we'd pray, and we'd worship some more, and it just. What I want to do is I want to sing that again, and if you can, if you're able to, and I like what CJ had said here from Second Chance Ministries last week on Sunday, when we all kneeled, that was powerful. Oh, it's a powerful position to be as a Christian. Is like I said, we're really in the church today. We're very rich, it seems, in theology, but we're very low on neology. And it's when we're on our knees and humbling ourselves. And you know, we could say a lot of things, but sometimes, you know, it helps, because the physical precedes the spiritual. This is a very, this is powerful. We're saying to the Lord, I'm all yours. We're saying to the Lord, without you, I can't take another step. We're saying to him, you're my Lord, you're my Savior, you're my King, you're my everything. I surrender all to you. This is where we receive power. This is where souls are birthed and won into the kingdom of heaven. This is where great churches are built on and are sustained. I'm going to say that again. The great churches are birthed and sustained when there is a remnant, a group, a people that understand this is where it's at. So what I want to do here tonight is just, if you can, if you'd like, we're going to open up the altars. If you want to come and just kneel at the altars, if you want to kneel at your seat, if you can make it to the altar, that'd be great too. And let's just worship the Lord. And just, like I said, I know some maybe physically are not able to get on your knees, but if you're able to, let's do that. And let's just worship the Lord and just wait upon the Lord here tonight. Hallelujah.
Risen and exalted. give you my soul. I live
the healing power of God is in this place as we continue to worship the Lord. So yeah, prayer and worship, prayer and worship, prayer and worship, prayer and worship. It's that simple. Prayer and worship. As we continue to worship the Lord in this place, start to thank the Lord for your healing right now. Start to thank the Lord for your healing tonight. The healing power of God is in this place tonight. Start to thank the Lord for your healing. Come on, come on, come on. Hallelujah.
My Jesus, my
Dealing with an addiction. Now, an addiction that, so when we say an addiction, it comes in different forms, amen? God wants to deliver you. God wants to heal you tonight. If that's you, and just so, and I'm gonna have my dad pray for every one of you here tonight, but line up like in a straight line, not behind each other, just in a straight line here in the front. Come on. Right there. Straight line right there. Come. Yes. The rest of us in worship and in prayer now. Come on now. Remember Paul and Silas. The jailer and his family got saved. Jail doors opened up. Chains came loose. Not before, but after they prayed and worshiped. Amen? Come on now. Hallelujah. Come on. Let's just worship, and pray. Let's intercede for these right now.
Show your glory. worship, 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 worship. Come on, together.
Glory today.
now, come on now.
You are mine. We will be.
together forever. Forever, I am yours. You are mine. We will be together forever. I am yours. You are mine. We will be together forever.
There's so much that's going on in our midst here in this house. So many testimonies. So much that's going on. God confirming His word. This past Tuesday, I don't know if you were here. Whoever was here Tuesday, what a powerful night. I mean, just the way the Lord confirmed. And so many testimonies and the souls that have been saved the last few months and the healings, the restoration that's taking place in families. I mean, I want you to understand, don't take this for granted. This isn't something, you know, this isn't an emotional thing we're doing. This is real. You know, and I know, but there's always a few that kind of, this is real. You know how you know it's real? Because there's fruit that speaks. Watch this. There's fruit. And we're good. You know what? Let's Jesse, why don't you stick with, just stay with us tonight. Just stay with us for the rest of the, you guys, we're good for the rest of the night. We're good. And then just, Jesse, you just kind of play in the background because I like that right now. The way you know what's God or what is not of the Lord or what's real or what's not real or the fruit, the Bible says, by their fruit you shall know them. The fruit confirms the word that goes forth. I mean, every time I turn to the left or to the right, someone's always like testifying and the word that's gone forth and from 3 months ago and 4 months ago, and you won't believe this and you won't believe that, and this happened and that happened, and my family's being restored, and I got, you know, people. I mean, that's a big one, the family part. We've been talking about that family business, amen? We need to protect this. We need to pray. We need to understand that God has entrusted us with much in this place. God's given us a platform. This is a hospital. And the hospital and the doctor is in, and we need to get the word out and not just make it, watch this now, just about us, but let's let others know that there's help here. There's, I know a place that can help. There's people that we know at work that need help, and we have this platform that God's given us. God has given us this hospital to help others. Let him know. Bring him in. And God will do the rest. Vernon, I just want you to, I just looked at our brother here, and I'm just so proud of you, man. You guys are doing so good. I mean, since you've come here and going out and sharing the Lord. Usually him and his wife are sharing the same shirts this time, you know, but they usually come in with all the other, they got like some of the coolest shirts, amen. Amen. But with little sayings and stuff like that, amen. But anyway, I just want you to take a couple minutes and just share what's on your heart right now, because I believe God's going to use you to speak to some hearts in here.
Well, praise God, everybody. Well, you know, what God has on my heart right now is souls. You know, that's the purpose, you know, that Jesus Christ came into this world was to, you know, save souls and to heal people, you know, and that's the main cause of this church. That's the heart of this church. That's the heart of our pastor. And if we can just catch on to that, catch on to the vision and run with it, then oh, what God will do, how God will work and manifest in our lives, you know. I mean, just the multitude of souls that, you know, come to the altar, you know, every service. It's fantastic. It's wonderful. You know, I mean, it's God, you know. And I mean, you know, that amps me up, you know. I can't contain the testimonies that are inside of me. And so, you know, it bubbles inside of my spirit whenever I'm out and about, you know. It doesn't matter where I'm at, you know. It's important that we don't bypass nobody. You know, I mean, if God has delivered us, if God has set us free, you know, if God has done something for us, and I know God has done something for all of us, we should not be ashamed to tell it. We should not be ashamed to tell it, but we should proclaim it. Because our testimonies can be the breakthrough of someone else's life. What God has done for us, whether it be an addiction, you know, or whatever it is that you're currently going through, you know, God is able to deliver you, set you free and heal you, to restore you. You know, he specializes in that. You know, but I mean, my heart, you know, my heart is for the people. You know, it's for the people. And yes, we do have a platform. And it's not only inside the church. It's not only behind the pulpit. But Jesus said, go ye into the world and preach the gospel to every creature. That's what he said. That's the commission that he gave all of us. And that's what we must do. It's a command to go into the world. Whether if it's at your workplace, at a drive-thru, your next door neighbor, tell somebody about Jesus. Because it's Jesus. Jesus is the answer. Glory be to God.
Shall I receive that? All he has to do is like.
Praise the Lord. What happened tonight here, not with our power. I stayed back there. I sit down and the Lord spoke to me. I released the healing power in this place tonight. For an addiction and arthritis. I tell my sister, Locula, there, I say, Lord, the release the healing power here tonight. Say, that way I come here. Receive it. What we ask you tonight, receive it. We pray, and by faith, you are healed. You are healed. Only receive it. All right? I pray. He's pray, but he's a healer. Our doctor in the heaven. Isaiah 53:5, what they say? With your stripe, with my stripe, you are healed. Our doctor over there, they wait for us and heal us. Give all the glory, all the honor to him and receive it tonight. What we you ask him. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. And so much more that God has for us. And I just, it's like almost 8:30. So, amen. Let's take a couple minutes. Let me just it's been in my spirit so I just want to, let me just release this also, because maybe it's just for one person. Maybe just one person needs to hear this. I don't know. Everyone else might already have this and has gotten a good hold of this. And it might just be for one person that needs to hear it, and that's their breakthrough and their victory. And because the Bible says that people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, lack of understanding. And as I was coming back from California after visiting my pastor last week, there was an In-N-Out Burger I stopped in. And you've heard me speak on In-N-Out before. And the simplicity of it. 1, 2, 3. I like that. Sometimes we, you know, it's like, it's so simple. And my whole experience every time, and this is like, now, this is between California and Arizona, somewhere in between. I forget where I stopped. I went and got some gas, and there was an In-N-Out. I forget what the little town was or what the area. Now, they're everywhere now, you know. But the thing is, what caught my attention once again, what really captured my attention was every time I go to In-N-Out Burger, just for myself personally, the experience has always been like at the highest level of excellence. From the beginning, but all the way to, watch me now, to the way they finish the thing. The whole process of it. Not just when you're in line where they start the process and the smile. And I mean, I don't think I've ever been in an In-N-Out Burger where someone hasn't smiled, has not been polite, has not been just, you know. I mean, it's just like, and then the order, and then the consistency of even the timing of how long it takes just to get your food. And then when you do get your food, it's just fresh. It's exact. It's always great. So not just the beginning of the journey there, but all the way to the end, they finish the thing right. And could it be that's why they're having so much success? So much success. And I believe their success is in how they handle what's been given to them and how they finish it. And how many people have been in places where they start strong but they don't finish strong? And how many people realize this also, that what people remember is not really the beginning, but they always remember the last thing you did? Jesus said on the cross, "It is finished." John 19:30, "It is finished." His assignment, his purpose was the cross. His assignment, his purpose was not to stop at the garden. It was not just to raise Lazarus from the dead. I mean, that would have been pretty good just if he would have just stopped there. Wow, you know, and did some, but the assignment would have been incomplete if he would have stopped with the miracle of Lazarus or the healing of the blind and the opening of the deaf to hear. Or it would have been incomplete also if he would have stopped in the garden. But what did he say when he was praying? He says, "Not my will, but your will to be done." Strengthened at that moment to finish the assignment. By finishing the assignment, it set up a glorious resurrection. Finishing the assignment positioned Jesus for 3 days later, the tomb was empty. When we finish what we start, we position ourselves for increase. We position ourselves for a greater promotion. We position ourselves to go higher, to go further. The way we finish something and how we finish it dictates success or lack of success, increase or lack of increase. What am I saying? People remember the thing you did, not in the beginning of a thing. You can do great in a big, you can start a project. And I mean, you are putting all your effort in that project. For example, maybe it's picking up a vacuum. So you started with the assignment of, I'm going to vacuum a certain area or clean up a certain area. And you can put everything you have into it. But then you leave a little area. You're like, that's good enough. I mean, it's getting, you know, I mean, you know, that's enough. But you know what people will see? Not the part that you cleaned up. It's that one area that was left. And at that point, you're telling God with your incompleteness, because God is not a God of incomplete. God is not a God of going halfway. He's in the business of starting a thing and finishing a thing. So he says, what I've started, I'm going to bring to completion. So when you touch something, when you commit to something, no matter what level, it could be even, let's say at school, a paper, and you've started something. Look at something, say, finish it. Because by finishing it, you're telling God, watch this, every time you touch something, you commit to something, you start something. We always talk about all the construction that's going on. What do we always say? Before we start the next thing, let's finish this thing first. Let's finish strong. We always clean up the area. Even when we did this area right here, Pastor Tony would come in. It's like, man, when I came here in the morning, you know, when we pick up again to start to finish this area, when we had finished, we'd finish every night. The group that was here every night, we would clean it up as if the project was over. That was the truth. We tear it down, we clean up, we vacuum, we put up fresh plastic, we cover the floor once again with new plastic, as if, watch this, and the thing wasn't finished. But the end of the day, late at night, the group that was here, and so many that helped, we would finish every single night here with this project as if it was over. It was done. It was complete. So the next day when we'd start, the place was ready to go, and there wasn't a mess. And I know Pastor, that was one of his remarks. He goes, this really helped us not fall behind because everything was cleaned up and put back in order so we can just pick up now and push forward. But we have a tendency as a people to start stuff, not finish it, and then try to start other things. And then what we have is a big salad without salad dressing. That's a word. That's why I love In-N-Out. 1, 2, 3, they start, they finish with excellence, and God has blessed that business. Yes, he has. Simple, but they know how to finish. They finish strong. So when I left In-N-Out, as much as I remember now a little bit in the beginning, but my experience again is when I leave that place, just the excellence of how they complete and finish what they started when you walk in there. Every time. And people always remember the end of a matter. There's a tendency to forget the beginning. So what I'm trying to say is finish right. Finish strong. Don't stop in the middle of something that you have committed to. No matter how, whatever that might be, if it's a 2-week thing, if it's a 4-year thing, if it's a 5-year thing, if it's a 1-year thing, if it's, as I said, as simple as vacuuming an area and that's what you commit, then do it and do it right and finish right, because by finishing, you're telling God, you can trust me with another project, and you can trust me with a project even greater than the one you just gave me. Where we get in trouble, watch this, and we get stuck. We start stuff, and some of it seems so insignificant, we think it's small. So it's like, it's no big deal. But you know what? God is watching you.
God is watching me to see how we handle the vacuuming. Or I'm just using these as examples. How about the bathrooms? When we do the bathrooms and clean up the bathrooms. But then when I walk in there sometimes at the end of the night, you know, when it's all been done, everything looks great. But you know what I look at? I'll see the one basket that hasn't been emptied. And that's the one that I go throw out at the end of the night. If we can't finish that right, how are we going to be entrusted with a bigger amount or a greater platform if we can't? Do you see? What I'm saying is, when you touch something and you commit to something, finish it. And let the finish be greater than what the way you started. Because that's preaching a message to the people around you, and you don't know who's watching you, and your promotion is connected to that person that's watching. And they're seeing how you finish something, and you are being set up for something great. Amen. Or someone's watching and saying, okay, and seeing the end of the thing that is not finished right. And that opportunity is lost because they're thinking, well, I was thinking about that person, and I was thinking about giving that promotion. I was thinking about making that person manager. But if I'm going to entrust them with a higher level here, and they can't do this job or this chore that they committed to and said yes to, how am I going to trust them with something greater? And that's what some increase and some do not increase, because people always remember the end of a matter. Always remember that. Whenever you start something, finish strong. When you're at work, finish strong at the end of the day. There's a tendency to get there, start strong, but at the end, get tired a little bit, get a little weird, you know, and we just kind of like, okay, well, you know, and we have a tendency not to do our job as well or as well as we first started, and we start to take shortcuts. Look at somebody, no shortcuts. Amen. Jesus finished his assignment. 3 days later, there was a resurrection. And if we want to see increase, the way we walk into increase is how we finish the thing before. And by finishing right, we position ourselves like Jesus. So sometimes it's the little things that we say, it's no big deal, but they are a big deal, because little things are not, you know, we think they're small, but small things, big things start with small things. A forest fire starts with a... In Jesus' name. I'm just going to stop right there. In and out. 1, 2, 3. Simple, focused. They start, they finish great. You know that. There's excellence. And that's why people continue to go back. I mean, that's the truth. And don't get busy trying to do multiple things. That's what I'm saying. Do it. If you're going to do one thing or you're going to do a couple things, do it and do it right. Better do 1 or 2 things than try to do 10 things and not finish them and be in the arena or on the board, but you're not hitting the bullseye. Do 1 or 2 things and do it good, do it great, do it with excellence, finish strong, amen. And that's where the power is, and that's where the victory is, amen. You know, sometimes you go into some of the places too, they say, like, you go into some of these restaurants or these like fast food, and they got the menus, like there's like 50 things to order from. It's like a hamburger place, but it's like 50 different things. I'm like, man, it stresses me out, amen, you know? No, amen. And some, you know, but you go to some places though, that they have like a lot of stuff sometimes. No, I'm, you know, I mean, I'm not saying tall, but I mean, it's okay when you order something, but it's not like In-N-Out though. Let's say if it's burgers, but they specially, I mean, you get that burger if it's 1, 2, or 3, if it's a double or whatever, amen. Like I got grilled onions with mine with a, you know, I think that was number 2. I think it was the double. Was that number 2? I think that's where the double. Yeah, double. And what I'm saying is, though, what they do with excellence, the fries are fresh. In other words, they hit the bullseye. It's not a watered-down Mickey Mouse hamburger. It's tasty. The fries are tasty. You ever been a place where you just eat and it's like, how long these fries been sitting around for? I'm sure someone started strong that day with those fries, but they sure didn't finish strong, amen? So what do you remember? Do you remember when the fries, no, you don't remember when the fries went in the fryer, amen. And then, you know, and it's great and it's good in the beginning, but then, but if what I remember, let's say, when I walk in there is that they gave me some fries that have been sitting around for a long time. You get home and it's like, have they been sitting there for like an hour or two by themselves? You know what I mean? And they're not warm. See the finish of the thing. Where are you going to go back to? That place? Or are you going to go to 1, 2, or 3? Who gets the increase? The place that finished strong, finished right, and with excellence. Finish what you start. Finish what you start. Whatever the project is, if it's work, within the family, whatever it is, when you start it, finish it. When you commit to it, finish it. And finish strong at the end. Because people will always remember, watch this, how you finished. They'll always remember how you left the place. And that could be the difference between, in Jesus' name, amen. Let's take the offering. Praise the Lord. If you need an offering envelope, please raise your hand. Okay, we'll close with this tonight. If you need an offering envelope, there should be one in the seat pocket in front of you. And if not, for whatever the reason might be, if you just raise your hand, we'll get one out to you as quickly as possible. Praise the Lord. Are you glad you came tonight? Thank you for your presence here tonight. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your presence. And with Pastor Robbie that was here on Tuesday, I had a chance to share with him. We got talk with him yesterday, and we're just talking about the Tuesday night service and love this man's heart and his hunger to do things right and doing with excellence. But he was saying how we're talking about the service, and again, how he had some of his team here, and just after the service. And again, this is where don't ever take for granted or get comfortable with what's happening in here, because we're impacting many, not just our neighborhood, but ministries and churches. Ministries and churches are being impacted by the passion, the hunger, and the fire in this place. So after the service, and I say this again, just to, because we need to stay on guard, amen, and understand what a privilege God has given us here to impact so many in so many different ways. But he goes, afterwards he was getting text messages from his team. It's like, we need to do this at the church, we need to do that, and the praise and the word, and the main focus was the passion that we had here as a church for worshiping the Lord. And that really impacted their team and their group there, as far as just the hunger, and that's why, again, we can't rush the service, and it's got to let God be God. And in the midst of it, people are being touched, people are being healed, people are being delivered, and we're impacting many people, amen, for the glory of God. And I thought that was really awesome. And let's not lose that passion. Let's not lose that hunger. Let's keep the thing the thing. The hurting, the poor, the afflicted, the addicted, and the lost. Amen. Praise God. Look at someone and say, I love this church. Amen. Amen. Albert, why don't you pray for the offering? Now this young man here, amen. It's Psalm Y. They just came from New River to visit. I was just there with my dad on Tuesday morning. I'm trying to think, it feels like a month ago. Wow. And they got a little bit of time, and they said, let's go. We're going to Fire and Water. Praise the Lord. So that just blessed me when I was walking in. I'm like, come on, kids. That's why they're up here right now. Because this man has really blessed me, because and let everybody be encouraged in this room, amen. It's like the Bible says, you know, a righteous man falls seven times, but he gets back up. And I always get encouraged. You know, what I love about him is this. He's been through a lot. He's had his moments. But you know what? You haven't given up. And that ministers to me. That encourages me. And I want you to be encouraged out there, because he's been through some stuff. He's had some victories, and then he's had some defeats, where most people would have said, okay, I'm done. God will never, it's over. This is insane. This is crazy. The cycle of this thing. But you know what? Look at where you're at again. Look at you. You look great. Love you. And why don't you, we'll pray for the offering. And why don't you want a quick little testimony? Do you want to testify? Just encourage somebody before we close tonight. Okay, please.
Absolutely. Praise God. Yeah, don't give up. I just, what's today, the 26th or 27th? 4 days ago, celebrated a year back in Jesus and sober. Amen. Celebrated a year back in Jesus and clean and sober. And this, man, the struggle was just, the addiction, yeah, the struggle was, really, man, I was addicted to crack cocaine for many years, like 23 years, and, in and out of prison, broken marriage, broken relationships, all because of, really, man, it just, the Bible says we're led astray by the desires of our heart. We're led astray by those evil desires. But if we keep Christ first, we don't have to be led astray by those desires. Amen. You don't have to go down that road. This church and Pastor Gus has been so instrumental in my deliverance and in my healing. And I know Jesus gets all the glory. Amen. But Pastor Gus, he never gave up on me either. There was times he was upset with me, and rightfully so. Maybe not upset, just maybe disappointed. But he, you know what? But like he said, he always had an encouraging word for me. He always said, I love you. I love you. He said that many times, man. Many times when I was hurting, and I thought, everybody had given up on me, and I was serving. I was serving at this church, and I was serving at the Teen Challenge Phoenix Induction Center, and I fell, and I went astray for about a year. This was in 2011, and it wasn't the first time, but there was something that happened this last time that was really different. That where God really got my attention, and that was September 23rd of 2011, where I was back in my mess. I was back in sin. Now let's call it what it is. Amen. Let's take some responsibility. Okay, like David did when he Psalms 51. That was 9 months after that incident happened. That's a whole other message, a whole other night. But man, I was in a situation in Tempe, which Pastor told me not to move to Tempe, by the way. No, don't move to Tempe. That's not God. That's not God. That's not God, Robert. Okay, Pastor. Yeah. Well, as a result of moving there and getting caught back up in sin and going back into the world, I was almost murdered in my apartment. Three men came into my home with a .38 revolver to do a home invasion, and they came with the intent to rob me, and they pistol whipped me and left me in a pool of my own blood. And I have a metal plate in my jaw and my, some teeth missing because of it. And I can just remember being on my kitchen floor crying out, crying in terror,
I've never been in a situation like that. I've been in and out of crack houses and in places, horrible, shameful things, not bragging about it. But the unfruitful works of darkness will be exposed, the Lord says. And that's when God shines his light in there and pulls you out. If you're by his grace, amen, by his grace. I didn't get murdered, obviously, by the grace of God. But, you know, once again, it was just one of those things where it was like, man, what is it going to take, man? And Pastor didn't give up on me, and Papa and Mama Betsy, and everybody, every time I'd come through these doors, no matter what, they'd love on me. They'd love on me, and they'd encourage me. And it was a season. And long story short, I finally, after being back out in that cycle again and knowing, man, when you know the Lord and you've tasted that the Lord is good, amen, your sin is never going to be the same. Those pleasures that you once did before are not going to be the same. As a matter of fact, you're going to be miserable in them. You're going to be miserable. Thank God. You know? And I went back to Teen Challenge, man. I went back to Teen Challenge, and Pastor didn't even know it. He was like, wow, I didn't even know. I didn't kind of see that coming. Because I had left. I had went to Colorado. I had taken off. I was going to go to Colorado and pursue some things and run from some things. And God, you know, brought me back, man, in April of last year. And I just, April 23rd, I went back into the ranch for restoration. And God put me in the same bunk that I left from. He put me in the same bunk that I left from.
To finish.
Yeah, to finish. To finish. The same exact bunk. I mean, there's 24 dorms there. 48 bunks. Do you think that was by accident, coincidence? I don't think so. I don't think so. But, man, I am grateful. I am just really grateful. And I can tell you that no matter where you're at right now, I don't care if you fell 5 minutes before you came into church. If you're here right now and you're still breathing, God has not given up on you. God has not given up on you. His word says he'll never leave you nor forsake you. He doesn't leave us. We turn our back on him. But even when we're faithless, he's faithful. He's faithful. But he desires for us. He says, be ye holy, for I am holy. Sanctified, set apart for his glory. For his glory. To crucify the flesh. To put away the misdeeds that mortify. Paul said, mortify the deeds of the body. Mortify them. Crucify your flesh every morning. This flesh is warring against the Spirit of God every day. You know why I came for prayer tonight? I came up with these prayers for addictions. Oh, well, I've got a year, you know. And God said, get up there. Get up there. I'm still working on you. Get out of your seat and come to the altar, God says. Don't sit in that seat and hold on to that thing. And while I was up here, when Papa put his hand on my stomach, he said, come out. He told the root of that addiction to come out. The root. And I claim that healing tonight. I claim that deliverance tonight. In the name of Jesus, I claim to be delivered, set free, and whole tonight in the name of Jesus. Because when I felt that hand on me, I felt that thing come up out of there. I felt it come up out of there. It's real. It's real. Colossians chapter 1, 13 and 14 says, for I have delivered you from the power of darkness, and I have translated you into the kingdom of my dear son. Will you grab a hold of that tonight? Will you claim your deliverance tonight? Will you walk in it? Colossians 2, 6 and 7 says, walk in a manner. He says, walk in a manner that is worthy. I'm paraphrasing right now. But walk in a manner that is worthy of your calling. See, we got something to do on this end. We just can't leave here delivered and set free and just go live any way we want to or do whatever we want. No, the Bible is very clear. Fornicators, adulterers, liars, drunkards will not inherit the kingdom of heaven. Homosexuals will not inherit the kingdom of heaven. And I am not casting judgment. The word of God judges us. The word of God judges us. And I'm telling you, if you run into any one of those people, you remember what you once were before you came to the Lord.
and love on that person, because it's love that will win them to Christ. We've got to love them and pray them into the kingdom, but we also have to speak truth. We have to speak truth. We have to speak truth. It's the truth that shall set us free. It's the truth that'll keep me from going back down that alley and doing those things that God doesn't want me to do. Delivered and set free by the power of God tonight. And I felt the root come out. I felt the root come out. My knees buckled. Buckled by the power of the Holy Spirit. Nothing that I can accomplish on my own, but to surrender and to succumb to the things of God. To get good accountability around you. Good brothers that'll tell you, man, bro, you better think about that. Well, I don't know, bro. What do you think about this? Hey, who you submitted to? What did Pastor Rick tell you? You know, you committed to a year of staying out of a relationship. So, you know, yeah, God's real. It's to seek His face and His glory and those things. And if God wants you to have someone or something, it'll happen. It'll still be there. If it's God's will. If it's God's will. But for the meantime, surrender. Surrender and stay submitted to whoever you're surrendered to. If you're submitted to the Lord and to this house, then listen to Pastor Gus, because he knows what he's talking about. Papa knows. They know what they're talking about. When they minister to you and they tell you to go to the left and not to the right, man, you better hightail it to the left. You better hightail it to the left. Some of us had to learn the hard way. You don't have to learn the hard way. Don't give up. Don't give up. God is your redeemer. Amen. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We give you praise, honor, and glory tonight for the deliverance and the healing that took place here tonight. We worship you and you alone. We thank you that what you're doing in this house, Lord God, is mighty and powerful. And Lord God, we thank you right now for the giver, for the seed sower, Lord God. Because, Lord God, as that seed is sown, Lord God, your kingdom is being glorified. And Lord God, I just pray right now for everybody with an offering, Lord God, everybody with a tithe, and those that aren't able to, Lord God, tonight, that, Lord, you would bless them so that they would be able to. But I pray that you bless this offering tonight with the blood of Jesus and the power of the Holy Ghost, Lord God, because without that, Lord God, we're nothing. Apart from you, we are nothing, Lord God. So I pray you bless this offering, bless this house, your house, Lord God, that there would be multiplication and increase, Lord God. And I'm not talking a prosperity message. I'm talking the first thing to prosper inside of us, to be that spirit man, Lord God. And your spirit to be continue to be manifested in this place. Bless the giver tonight, Lord God. And the one that's not able to give, bless them double, that they would be able to give, and give them wisdom and discernment. And may we give from our hearts, Lord God. And we ask you to bless it tonight in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. Give a big God bless you. Amen. What we're going to do is, like, as we take the offering here and we finish with the offering, remember, it's not the way you start, it's the way you finish. Amen. So tonight, you know, as Robert shared his testimony, maybe you said that's me. Don't give up. Run to Jesus. Dude, it's like, right, you guys have a little bit of time. I just want to, if that's you tonight, what we're gonna do is, as we take the offering, and as we dismiss, if that's you, you've never given your heart to Jesus, because it starts with a relationship with Him. Maybe you've been away from God, and you find yourself here in church. You're like the prodigal son. It's not too late. You're here right now. You're breathing. There's still time to get it right. Maybe you're that person that just, like, 5 hours ago before coming in, did something that was completely contrary to the Word of God. God's grace is here right now to get it right. And if that's you tonight, I'm going to have Robert. And why don't you, you know, with the guys here, pray with them, lead them to Jesus. We'll have you guys just right. They'll be up here in the front, okay? right there. That's perfect. Praise the Lord. Someone say, well, Pat, you know what? What about the rest of the, you know, what about the, sometimes people always think like this sometimes. There's always one or two, you know. Pat, you know, but they're, you know, they're just visiting, and now they're going to leave people. Well, what about me? I've been here for, you know, why can't I do? Because God told me to do that. That's why. And just like that, it's that simple. And you should be excited where you're at to be in, and if someone starts walking this way, your job is to pray. You can be leading him like this, or you can be doing, it doesn't matter. He's the one that's bringing the increase. Your problem is, but no one can see me though. I want to be seen. Look, pastor called me up, and look, I'm the one that's putting it. Come on. Please. We don't got time for that kind of stuff in here, okay? It's his kingdom right now. Praise the Lord. And God's doing something with these guys also by doing this. So there's a lot going on here. Amen. So, again, we'll be back here tomorrow morning. Don't forget breakfast between 9 and 10. Free breakfast for some of you that have never been here before. We'd love to have you come back tomorrow. If you are here for the first time, we have Bibles in too. So if you need a Bible, we have the Bibles in the bookstore. We do have our gifts, our back DVDs are ready to go too. So if you're here for the first time, we do have a gift for you, and want to say as a way of saying thank you for coming tonight and trusting us with the things of God. So if you just stop in the bookstore, we'll get that into your hands. Amen. And then we'll be back here tomorrow morning. Of course, service starts at 10:30. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Lord, bless your people. I pray as they go home tonight, protect them, keep them. Give them good night's rest, Lord God. Sweet dreams from heaven. When they wake up tomorrow morning, refreshed, refueled, strengthened, Lord God, to glorify your name. I pray this in the name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you. Now, if you need prayer, if you've never given your heart to the Lord, or you've been away, please make your way up here, and these gentlemen will help you. Praise the Lord. God bless you.